When I was a kid, I constantly got homesick whenever I was away from my parents for one night, two nights, or many nights. In fact, it really didn't matter if I was simply just right down the road or an hour or so away. Whenever I was young, if I spent the night away from my mom or dad, I always longed to be with them. This even is something that I dealt with all the way into my early teenage years. When I think about longing for God, which I spoke about yesterday morning in my message, I think along similar lines, that we as followers of Jesus Christ are longing to connect to God in the same way that a young child is just wanting to be around his or her parents. And to be quite honest with you, in many ways, Scripture sometimes describes that longing in some sort of childlike sense. In fact, we talked about that from the Psalm of David yesterday in Psalm 63, verse 8, where David said that he clings to God and God upholds him with his strong right hand. In the same imagery, you would imagine a child clinging to his or her parent and that parent holding him or her in their arms. Some of you may be thinking something along this line. Chad, this longing for God stuff is great, but for some reason, I don't long for God like I probably should. Let me give you a word about that. See, every single human being has this innate sense for the divine. We have this innate longing for God. It's what is placed within us at birth. God created us, in other words, with this longing. And so it's not as if you don't have it. It's more like, according to Scripture, that the sinful nature and the things of this world sort of distract us, they blind us, or they douse this longing for God. So to help awaken your soul to the reality of God and longing to be with God and connected to God, one of the things that I would encourage you to do is try to find those things that seem to be taking precedent in your life over God. Maybe it's good things as well. Maybe it's the things of the world. Maybe it's your job. Maybe it's money. Maybe it's your hobbies. Maybe it's sports. I don't know what it could be. It could be of many different things. But as someone once said, if they had to describe our culture in three words, they would describe it as busyness, hurry, and noise. Sometimes the way that we can awaken this longing for God, this innate longing for God that every single one of us has at conception, we're given and created with this longing, some ways that we can arouse that or awaken that is that we can remove the distractions from our lives. Things like TV, things like keeping the phone away from us, things like turning off the computer or getting away from the internet for a while. See, many times what happens is this longing is sort of dampened because we start to focus on the things of this world. But that longing that is placed within us, placed there by God, is so important because that's why you and I were created, to connect and commune with God. So we want to make sure that we remove any barrier that may hinder that purpose. That's Monday's recap here. I hope that you all have a great week, and we will see you again on Sunday.